And from the warm confines of the new Sentinel Studios, I'm Vinnie Lopes, joined alongside by Tom Davis. And Tom, we sat through the cold, the rain, and the mud to be able to see Snider defeat Homestead in a battle of unbeatens in to open up the postseason tournament. And a pretty impressive performance by Snider, scoring 23 points to open up the game in this first half, and really just rolling from that point, being able to win 30-20.
They did. They opened up very, very well. Homestead didn't get a first down until 8 minutes left in the first half, and even that was the result of a Snider penalty. They forced three Homestead punts on their on the Spartans' first three drives, and they moved the ball very well. And then they got their 23rd, their final, that end of that scoring on a great play, a sack by Donovan Day, knocks the ball up in the air, Weston Painter hauls it out of the air and takes off 69 yards untouched down the field. Incredible play, but I will give Homestead credit. They could have rolled over and died right then because nothing had gone their way, and they were down 23 points to Snider, who only gives up 15 a game on average. But they didn't. They came right back, got a touchdown at the end of the first half, opened up the second half with another touchdown, and they really continued to battle. So I will give Sparty credit for not rolling over.
Yeah, and I do have to ask you, Tom, because, you know, going this week, you weren't necessarily critical, but you did point out, you know, that in
I was critical.
Homestead, you called the Homestead team soft.
Yes.
Did they show you something, though, tonight that made you change your mind about this Spartans team and maybe future Homestead teams?
Maybe for the future. As far as this team, definitely they did. Like I said, they could have quit and just lost 47-20 or something like that, but they didn't. They continued to fight and battle, and they moved the ball. They played pretty smart for the most part. You know, they ended up totaling 283 yards of total offense. They got 18 first downs. They ran the ball for 151 yards. If you're not tough, you're not going to run the ball for 151 yards against a Snider defense. And they won the time of possession. So, yeah, they did a lot of good things tonight, which was a really good sign for that program, which has lost 12 of the 14 times that they've played Snider.
Right. Now, Tom, looking at the team that was able to win this in Snider, and, you know, I don't think I've ever seen a team that would prefer to play in horrible, cold, rainy, muddy conditions as opposed to a nice sunny day. Like this Snider team, it's just an old-school football team of we're going to run and pound, we're going to play in miserable weather, and we're going to beat you methodically.
Absolutely. There's something to admire about the Snider program and the toughness that those kids have on both sides of the ball, in blocking it from the up front, the offensive line, to the runners. They would just rotate those three running backs. One series, it would be Nick Reese. The next series, it'd be Janori Smith. The following series, it'd be Tyrell Swain. I mean, they just rotated those guys through, kept everybody fresh, and the defensively, I don't know if there's a harder-hitting team that I've seen this year. But, yeah, they kind of reveled in the mud. They like their Spuller Stadium's nasty, muddy, slick field, which really hurts opponents that aren't used to it. So there's something just really nice about that Snider, watching that Snider program and its toughness. But I will say this. There's some weaknesses on that Snider program as far as this team that really concern me as we get deeper and deeper into the tournament. Again, they had a number of penalties tonight, unnecessary penalties, personal fouls. They had five for 56 yards tonight. Homestead had six, but only for 38 yards. And we saw a few weeks ago against Northside, Snider had a lot of penalties as well. And their passing game, Brandon Phelps, he does a nice job for the most part, but he takes chances. And when you get really deep in the tournament and play a great team, you can't take chances throwing into double coverage. And there were probably two passes hit Homestead defenders right in the hands, and they dropped tonight.
Well, it's going to be interesting for Snider as they make this postseason run, because four of the teams ranked in the top 10 IHSA's a coaches poll for Class 5A all went out in the first round. Carmel lost. Ben Davis lost. You had Homestead, of course, that lost. Right. And you had an undefeated Brownsburg lose. So the path is starting to look a – it's always tough to win a state championship. There's only been one Fort Wayne team to ever win a Class 5A championship, 1992 Snider. But – you're beginning to give the sense, seeing all these teams drop, that maybe, just maybe, this could be the year that the Panthers pull it off.
It could be, but before we get that far ahead, Northside has something to say about that in the sectional championship game. And I know the Northside coaching staff's going to look to Southside next week, and Snyder's going to worry about Wayne, which upsets Kokomo. But
hats off to the Generals.
Absolutely. Yeah. You go, boys. I tell you, that Northside team could possibly upset Snider as well. They have the athleticism. If they get on a dry field where their speed is not negated like it was the first time they played, seems like it's rained every Friday for the last 6 months, but you know, Northside could have something to say about that.
Yeah, well, it's going to be an interesting rest of the sectionals. Well, we were done with the first round. Crazy amount of upsets. It's October Madness, and be sure for all your high school football coverage, you go to news-sentinel.com. That's Tom Davis. I'm Vinnie Lopes. Have a great weekend.